In this video, I'll walk you through how you can add the review capability so that users can leave their feedback on your page, your business, etc. Here we go. So here I am on the Facebook page of Consortium Networking, a fairly new page that's set up. And if I click on reviews, you can see there's already one review there. And that's the most recent review. And that's myself having written that. Now, any review you get, I recommend you respond, you comment, you thank on behalf of the group. That's the best way to go with reviews, because each one of these is going to help you get more visible. Now, if that reviews option isn't available on your page for whatever reason, what you need to check is go to settings, and then you need to go to templates and tabs. Now, it depends what layout you have for your page currently. Mine is the services tab, but if you had the default tab or whatever, it may not be there. So if it wasn't there, you'd just say add a tab. Because you can't pick it out because it's there. But at the moment, you can enable here reviews on or reviews off. So if I turn that off and save that, and we go back to the page. Here on the left hand side, you can see there's no option to have reviews now. So it can be turned on and off. There's a difference now in the way people review. It's a written comment. It's not a star system, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If they say, do you recommend it? Yes. Then that's likely to be classed as a 5 out of 5. And if it's do you recommend? No. Then that might be counted as a lower rating. So caution around that. If I go back to a different view, which is the brand new 2020 version. Again, if I go back now to where I was in the menus before, which was the page settings, I go down here to settings, templates and tabs, and this time I go to where there's reviews, just enable it back on, go back to the home page, and you can see now that reviews are there. Now let's try another page. I'll go to my own business page, PR Wilson Media, and you'll note that here you can't currently review the page. It's not there as an optional tab. So what I need to do is go to the page settings again, go to templates and tabs, and go down to where it says reviews, and I need to make it more prominent on the page so it's in the top three. So I can do that by sliding it upwards. Yeah, let's see, a bit higher. And now if we go back to the page itself, you'll see hopefully that menu option appear. Not quite, but it's so it needs to slide along a little bit more, I suppose. But yeah, reviews are there. You'll see there's several here that have been left over time, and they can be left on, it can be removed. That's quite flexible. So there's a whole ratings and review system written here, a wizard that steps you through what's changed about it. Supposedly it's easier to recommend your page. I think it's added a layer of complexity. If I switch back to the normal classic view, we'll see it again. Within that view, so pretty similar really, it's just a slightly different outline, etc. So that's reviews and recommendations in 2020. I've been Paul from PR Wilson Media, your social media personal trainer. Cheers.